To our top story tonight, sporting codes in strife, calls for athletes to be named and shamed, calls for fans to boycott games. The sporting scandal that's taken our nation by storm refuses to go away. In a moment, we'll speak to a sports psychologist who's worked with elite athletes about the ramifications of the doping crisis. But first, Natasha Rex will be with the day's developments.
And so it begins, the witch hunt into which clubs are cheats. The Gold Coast Titans first off the draw, with reports a vial of urine was hidden inside the plumbing at their football ground.
We've had it confirmed that the vial of liquid found wasn't a vial, it's a jam jar. We believe that the liquid is urine, but we're not sure.
Police aren't pursuing the case, but sporting heavyweights want the drug cheats named so the innocent can clear their name.
We want to see some evidence, and if someone's been caught, well, then, you know, show them. Show us the people that have done the wrong thing.
At the moment, everyone's sort of tarnished, which is unfortunate. You know, every sport, every professional athlete.
Just over 24 hours since the bombshell, sports people across the board have had a gutful.
It's perhaps the blackest day in football history. There are a lot of other sports in Australia, such as ours, and many other clean sports, and I think to tarnish us all with the same brush is really unfair.
Here's what one sporting fan had to say to AFL CEO Andrew Demetriou on radio.
I would like to start a campaign, a movement by the entire Australian public that to boycott the opening round of all the three codes of AFL, NRL and A-League with the statement, we won't come to watch drug cheats.
We didn't find too many sporting fans who agreed with him, though.
Boycotting, it's crazy. You know, we should still go and see the games. But, you know, let's get rid of the cheats. They're horrible. That's all they are, cheats.
Look, I'm a big sports fan. Either way, I will still go along and support the team. I think it's terrible what's happened and come out about manoeuvred sports. Cycling, what happened with Lance Armstrong, really tainted that sport. So hopefully footy won't get associated in the same way, because that'd be terrible for the game.
The commission says it won't reveal any names at this stage because that would hinder the ongoing investigation into the criminals who are infiltrating the sporting codes. It may be months before we know who these cheats are.
Well, joining me now is sports and exercise psychologist Georgia Ridler. She's a senior advisor at the Queensland Academy of Sport. Georgia, thanks very much for your time. Look, federal MPs from both sides of politics are urging the Australian Crime Commission for more detail now on the extent of this crisis. Should we be naming and shaming the offenders?
Oh, look, I think there's a great risk in naming and shaming offenders at this point. I really think we need to be collecting as much information as possible to really understand the context in which these athletes and which athletes have been stuck in this situation. And the question is, have these athletes been doping willingly and openly, or have they been guided by, you know, scientists or sports medicine or doctors to take these drugs and things in order to enhance performance? We don't know which way, and it'd be really dangerous to shame and blame athletes for these behaviours when we're not really sure whether they've been innocently taking them or really openly taking them.
What about the impact, though, on the innocent athletes whose integrity is now under a cloud of suspicion?
Yeah, absolutely. Look, I think our athletes who've been playing by the rules have many questions going on, and I've seen a lot of little Facebook messages going on that they're thankful that ASADA has taken such a step. I think also, you know, there's a bit of fear that this media is obviously getting out worldwide and what that means for them as they travel into competitions over the next year or so. But I think overall, athletes are pretty thankful that the system is catching athletes that are cheating through this kind of system.
Georgia, you've spent close to a decade working with Olympians and gold medalists across a range of sports. Can you give us an idea, some sort of an insight into the psychology that's driving these athletes to cheat? What sort of pressure are they putting themselves under at this elite level?
Sure. Look, you know, particularly at the professional level, not just the elite level, but, you know, in our professional codes, athletes are being paid big amounts of money to perform, and not just perform in terms of their contract over a year, 2 years, 5 years, but they're required to perform and compete every day for their role, for their position in a team. And this is money that's going towards their mortgages, their homes, their livelihoods, their families, and hence it is really important that we get really clear about who has done what and when and why before we go out and do some naming and shaming of our athletes.
Georgia, do you expect to see the stress of this scandal start to take an impact on the actual performance of some of these players?
Absolutely, absolutely. Like, you know, particularly athletes who haven't been open and willing in taking these substances and have, been trusting in personnel to take these things, it would have a huge impact on their performance and how they feel in front of people, and obviously the fans and the impact that the fans will have at games. It'll be interesting to see how some of these athletes perform, but also how the athletes who've been playing by the rules, how they cope under the pressure and assumptions in terms of athletes feeling like they're guilty by association.
Tough times ahead for all the athletes, no doubt. All right, Georgia Riddler, thanks very much for your time tonight.
You're welcome. Thank you.